Hello everyone, I'm Mr. South. This is my grammar assistant for today, Mr. Porter. We are full lesson in 10 PE, and today we are looking at the triple jump. So we're going to start off with a full range of lesson objectives that you can pick from depending on the ability of your class.
And here is how I would set up the triple jump lesson. So on the yellow cones, I would actually have a pile of four cones. The other three could come in handy later. And the red cones just mark out a space for the students to move around in. So moving into space, then I would get them to experiment with the following three jumps. Strong foot to seine foot, which will eventually relate to the hop phase of the triple jump. Strong foot to other foot, which will relate to the step phase, and the final phase, other foot to both feet. So the students will try those jumps out during the warm-up, and I will talk about the strong foot being the foot that students would feel comfortable with kicking a football. And moving on. After the warm-up, students can work in pairs and begin putting those jumps from the warm-up together to create the correct order of phases for the triple jump. I will show you a more creative way of doing this in a more of a guided discovery format later, but you might want to go with more of a command style if you're looking to move to the sand pit, if you have a sand pit later on in the lesson and get students to record some scores. It might be preferable to do this in a more command style. So going through in order, those different phases, and students just to start with performing them all together as you call them out. Just starting to embed in the student's memory the correct order of those jumps. The partner can obviously act as a coach in this and look for any mistakes and then provide that feedback if necessary. When your students are ready, then they can start having a practice at jumping for distance. But just bear in mind that you don't want to spend a whole lesson jumping on a hard surface. High intensity jumping on a hard surface is going to lead, or could potentially lead, to injuries. So if you're going on to the sand pit later in the lesson, then doing a bit of jumping like this is fine, but don't be doing it for the full 50 minutes or hour, however long your lesson is. Also be aware that a common mistake that the students will make is they'll try to jump as far as possible on the first phase of the triple jump, and then they may well be off balance for the next two phases. So if you notice that happening, stop the lesson and then give the students a drill to stop that from happening. So from the end point, or from the finish point of the student's jump, then mark back equal distances using the cones that we placed on the yellow cone earlier. Use those extra cones to mark equal jump distances to that end point. So when students retry, they should be a lot more balanced and should be able to get further than their previous personal best. So use those extra cones just to mark out equal distances for the three phases, and then encourage the students to be balanced, and hopefully they'll have a more efficient movement that way. Now, if you are lucky enough to have the full triple jump facilities, then it's a great chance to get the students to have the full experience and set a personal best. Now, it does give us a slight problem in that we've got cues, which is usually a big no-no in PE, but we'll try and limit that damage by creating three different job roles. So we have our measurers here, we have our takeoff judges here, and we have our jumpers here. We can have two at a time because we've used a cone to turn the long jump lane into a triple jump lane as well. So it'll look a little bit like this. We've got our jumpers complete their jump, our measurers come in, give me a score which I can note down on my register, and then those judging the takeoff can give me a thumbs up or thumbs down. Then our jumpers can move to here, our measurers can move to here, our takeoff judges can move to here, and it's a fairly fluent, quick process.
Right, so to ensure that the students have legal jumps, we're going to have to teach them how to mark their run-up. So this is what we do. We've got Mr. Porter with both heels, not just one, both heels against the takeoff mark. And then from there, he's going to sprint for three steps. We'll just do a three-step run-up for now. A three-step run-up, and then I will mark where that third step lands, and that will be where he starts his run-up. Okay, so when you're ready, Mr. Porter. Okay, so that's where his third step was. That's where he'll start his run-up.
So an alternative way of teaching the triple jump, especially with year sevens who are doing it for the first time, is to use more of a guided discovery approach. So I would have three different color cones and then label them on the whiteboard, three different landing positions. So landing on our strong foot, landing on our other foot, or landing on both feet. And then I'd get two students, so in pairs, to gradually, they can create their own jump. So combination of jumps. So one student would go and they would pick a cone, any of the three, and lay that down. The next student would go and repeat what the first student's done and then add an extra cone. Then this would continue. So it's almost a test of memory of the students to see how far they can get performing this jump that they are creating. If I want to make it a bit more difficult for a higher ability pair, then I can take those cones out and then really test their memory to see if they can remember this jump they've created. So it's a bit of a fun task to start the lesson and get the students used to these different types of jump. And then I would call them in and show them a video of a triple jump. So a video very similar to this one, play it a few times, and the students can look at what those phases are and then go and create that jump with their coloured cones. So hopefully when the students have had a little bit of deliberation and have come to their final answer, you should have a setup a little bit like this that helps the students identify what those three phases are, and then they can practice from this point.
So technique-wise for triple jump, the main thing is getting those phases in the correct order and nice and fluent. But if you want to start adding a few technical aspects in, then it's important to stay upright through the jump, to use your arms for leverage, especially in that final phase, and also to try and get your hip up to a 90 degree angle during the phases. So hopefully that was helpful. If you enjoyed it, like the video, subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Thank you.